Joining us is Philonise Floyd. He's the brother of George Floyd, as well as Benjamin Crump, the Floyd family attorney. Nice to see both of you this morning. Philonise, I just want to start with how you're doing, how your family is doing since your brother's funeral. I know that sometimes things can get actually even harder for the family after the funeral. So how are you?
As of now, we all just, you know, sticking together. Just loving on each other and just trying to stay a family and intact, because everybody is having hard times right now, because you constantly see that video everywhere and people talk about it so much, and you think about your brother or your cousin or your uncle constantly.
Yeah, I can understand that. Are you surprised by what has happened in this country over the past 3 weeks? I mean, this weekend, there were still active, big protests in many cities about your brother.
Well, he was a loved person by a lot of people, but everything that's going on, people are just tired. Enough is enough. You constantly see people dying every day, Black people dying. We just want equal justice. We want the same justice as white America and Black America. We all need to come together and be united as one.
I think that your words have really resonated with so many people. I know when you spoke in front of the House Judiciary Committee, you know, you sent a message that so many people felt was really passionate and poignant. And so when you see what happened this weekend, the case of Rashard Brooks in Atlanta, do you see that in the same vein as what happened to your brother, or do you see that in a different category?
To me, it's basically, they're just two different cases. My prayers go out to the family, you know, because I know how hard it is to lose someone close. But there's just two different cases. It's like apples and oranges.
Yeah, Mr. Crump, what about you? I mean, legally speaking, as a lawyer, do you see this in the same vein? Should we see this all in the same vein as what happened to George Floyd?
Well, I think each case is different. Allison, Breonna Taylor is different. Rashard Brooks is different from George Floyd. But each of them involve unnecessary death of a Black person in America. And I feel terrible, because when we testified before the United States Congress, I said to them, if we don't have a change in culture and behavior in policing in America, I predicted, and this was last Wednesday, that there would be another killing of a Black person in America and another hashtag. Well, that was on Wednesday. It was only 2 days later. And then you had Rashard Brooks killed in Atlanta.
And Mr. Crump, from your vast experience, unfortunately, with so many of these cases, do you think that both of those police officers, from what you've seen in the body cam video, do you think they'll be charged with crimes?
It's hard to predict, because we haven't heard the audio of what was said by police officers. We only heard different accounts. What I will say is this: we in Black America have seen white suspects of DUI handled much differently. Normally, these minor interactions with police with white people end up as just that, a minor interaction. But with Black people in America, somehow they end up being fatal. And that is what's troubling to us, because as Philonise said, we can't have two justice systems in America, one for Black America and one for white America. We do have to have equal justice for the United States of America, and that means policing too, because for many Black Americans, that's when the justice system first presents itself to our community.
Philonise, as I said, so many people watched your testimony in front of the House Judiciary Committee. Did you feel, I mean, tell us what happened sort of behind the scenes. Did you feel that lawmakers were really listening? Did they tell you that they were going to take some specific action?
Well, I think the world was listening. When I was in there, I just was speaking from the heart and just letting them know how I felt about everything when it comes to policing, and they need to get their jobs right. It hurt me to lose my brother, but I don't want to see that happen to anybody else around the world. If they get their jobs right the first time, they'll never have to worry about it the second time.
You have been such a strong advocate and voice for unity. I mean, that's the one thing that you keep, even in your pain and your family's grief, you have talked about just wanting people to be able to come together and work together and live together. But is there one thing on the policing front, say, that you think could make a big difference, Philonise? Is there one thing you'd like to see them take up next week?
Just make sure they wear their body cams all the time. Everybody need to know what's going on. I don't want to see nothing hitting. No, you like hitting agendas. You pop up and see different things. Everybody needs to know what's going on at all times, because if you don't have it on, obviously you must be doing something wrong.
You want transparency, and I think that that is an urgent call that a lot of people want. Mr. Crump, 7 Minneapolis police officers have resigned since George Floyd's death, and the latest reporting that we have is that more than half a dozen are in the process of leaving, according to department officials. Do you know what that's about?
Well, what we understand, Allison, is people understand that it wasn't just the knee of Derek Chauvin, the officer that killed George Floyd. It was the knee of the entire Minneapolis Police Department that killed George Floyd. It was systemic in that police department, and maybe these officers are responding that they feel there should be better policies and procedures, not only to protect the public, but also to protect them.
So you think it's a protest vote of some kind? It's just hard to know if they're who they're angry at, or, you know, why they're resigning.
Well, you know, when you look at the history of that department, you see officers may have been trained improperly. Obviously, there were 4 officers on the scene for 8 minutes and 46 seconds that watched George Floyd say, "I can't breathe," 16 times and beg for breath, but none of them did anything. And so maybe they're protesting, saying, "We need better training, Minneapolis Police Department, because you all are jeopardizing us to prison and jeopardizing innocent citizens to death. And so we have to have better, Minneapolis."
Philonise, I don't know if you've seen a preview of the upcoming cover of The New Yorker magazine, but if not, let me describe it to you. It's on our screen right now. It is the full cover, basically, of your brother. It's your brother George's face and head, and then there's kind of a collage of different faces, black faces, people who have been killed after police interactions that make up his body. And I mean, it's really a stirring image. And I'm wondering what you think of that and what you think your brother would think of it.
If my brother knew that he could change the world for passing like this, I think he would have did it. But it's difficult to just look at him and also see all those people who passed away before him and people after him too. It's devastating just thinking about it right now. I just want justice for my brother. And after that, I feel we'll be one step closer to the world being together all over again, because everybody wants justice right now.
And I know I've asked you this before, but today, what does justice mean for you?
Justice as of today is all those officers being convicted. And that's one step closer, because justice is lasts forever. When in any state, at any time, everybody need to be on point. We need all police to do their job the right way, and that's justice for me. I don't want to see innocent people dying, none of that.
Philonise Floyd, Benjamin Crump, we really appreciate having your voices on New Day. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm.